Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this topic we are going to talk about what are the different physical as well as the chemical properties of carbon. So in this case basically we are going to talk about the physical appearance as well as we could also say that what are the different chemical reactions that could be exhibited by the carbon as well as the other other compounds that consist of carbon. So now let us understand that is what are the physical and chemical properties of carbon. So certain physical property that I want to talk about is the first one, that is, as we know that carbon is basically a non-metal. So we could say that the first point, that is carbon is basically a non-metal. And this carbon has a property of showing the catenation also. So therefore carbon, that is, it exhibits catenation. This is even a property of the carbon. And talking about the next one, that is carbon has various allotropes, like as we have discussed earlier, that is diamonds, fullerenes and graphite. As well as they can also conduct electricity, or they like in graphite as well as in that is fullerene. But talking about carbon, so carbon is not reactive with that of the water molecule. That's the reason that that carbon is basically used in electrolysis method for decomposition of water molecules so as to liberate H2 as well as O2. So in that case also the graphite rods are being used. So this were the certain kind of that is property that I was talking about. And talking about the other one, that is the carbon, they doesn't react with any of the compound very easily. Obviously there are two forms, that is amorphous and crystalline form. So the crystalline form, that is whenever it is related to diamond or whenever it is related to that is graphite, they don't react easily. But meanwhile, this carbon has also various uses or applications. So there is a separate lecture on that, so we are going to talk about that also later on. But for a brief thinking, let me talk about that is they are used in basically industries so as to prepare that is coke, and that coke is basically used in purification of metals in blast furnace also. So there are certain reactions that I'm going to talk about, and that is basically chemical properties. So now let us discuss about the chemical properties. So whenever we are going to talk about the chemical property, let us understand whether the carbon is being reactive with that of the oxygen or not. So let me talk about the first one, that is what happens when the reaction of carbon takes place in presence of oxygen. So as I have said earlier, that is a pure carbon, that is a diamond, that won't react with oxygen easily. But if we talk about the substance like coke, so the coke consists of carbon. So in this case basically we could say that coke, it can easily react with oxygen, and that is all providing a certain amount of heat so as to form that is carbon dioxide, that is CO2. So this is happens when we supply excess amount of oxygen, so that the combustion reaction would take place, and that's the reason that we could get or the oxidation reaction of the carbon takes place and we could get that is carbon dioxide. But this is happened when we have provided the excess amount of oxygen, and that is what we have got carbon dioxide. But what happens if we provide limited quantity of oxygen? So in this case basically, if the carbon consist of, or it has been provided with a limited quantity of oxygen, then in that case basically the product that we could get is basically carbon monoxide. So therefore we could say that the carbon has a capacity or have a tendency to form dioxide as well as monoxide. And since carbon has a valency of 4, so therefore overall we could say that the electronic configuration, whenever a molecule has been formed because of the carbon, so it forms a very stable electronic configuration. And that's the reason that suppose if you talk about CCl4, so that CCl4 is now been surrounded by 8 electrons, and since it has been completing its octet, so therefore either it neither act like a Lewis acid or either it acts like a Lewis base. So that's the reason that was also a kind of chemical reactivity that I was talking about. So talking about this one, that is, this is carbon monoxide, and this has also wide applications of it. So we are going to talk about each of it in the later lecture, but now let us talk about the other reactions. So talking about the other reaction, that is what is the reaction of the carbon with that of the halogen. So talking about the next property, that is what happens if the carbon is being treated with the halogen molecule. So it has been noted that suppose if carbon is been treated with the halogen molecule, like if I mention here as 2x2, and that could be fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. So and this is what we have discussed in our that is during the introduction of group 14 elements also, we have discussed some kind of reactions as well as the properties. So in this case basically the product that we could get is, it is basically CX4, basically known as carbon tetrahalide. and especially if you talk about CCl4, that is carbon tetrachloride, that carbon tetrachloride, it is a compound which is basically very stable in nature, and that's the reason that because of that nature, it is basically used in fire extinguisher. So that has a various property or various applications in the various field. And talking about the next one, that is during this halogenation process, we can also convert the carbon into freons. And what is freon? Suppose if we have, that is carbon along with that of F2 and Cl2. So this is basically interhalogen, that we could see that there are two different halogen atoms that are being associated with carbon atom, and this is basically known as freon. So this freon is basically it was widely used in refrigerants so as to give a cooling effect, and that's the reason that it CFC, when we talk about carbon fluorocarbon, so they are basically nothing but they are a type of freons, and that are basically, it was used in refrigerants. So that was a property where we could also form freons because of the carbon. And there are also a few properties where we could say that because the carbon has a basically wide applications in industries, so that's the reason there are oxide that are been formed, like as I have mentioned earlier. So they have been used in the extraction of pure metals, and somewhere it is also been used in removing the impurities. So that was the thing that I was talking about, and that's it. So this was regarding, that is, the reaction of carbon with halogen, as well as in industry application we have talked about. But there are also some kind of chemical reactivity, let me talk about that, where basically they can react to form carbide. So what are those? Let me talk about that. So now let me talk about carbide. So carbide is the main a substance where which consists of carbon as a main substance. And now let me talk about the carbides, like we could say like calcium carbide and silicon carbide. So these are the substance where we could find that the carbon is associated with that substance or that element which is having the same electronegativity or almost that is same electronegativity. So therefore, if we talk about the calcium carbonate, that is CaC2, this calcium carbonate, whenever it is been treated with H2O, so the product that we could get is basically an alkyne, that is HC triple bond CH, along with that of, that is calcium oxide. So therefore, we could say that even the carbides are basically very much essential so as to give a particular reaction whenever it is been treated with water. So this is how basically we can prepare or we can synthesize ethyne. And so let me talk about the various applications of this also. For example, if we talk about carbide like SiC or boron carbide, so in this case basically it has been noticed that the boron carbide is basically very much stronger than that of, or very much hard than that of the silicon carbide. So they have applications in basically in preventing the radiations. So there were this topic that I was talking about, and that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to know about the various physical as well as the chemical property of carbon. So I'll see you in the next lecture. Till then, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.